Hi, I'm Dr. Kayla Daniel, the naughty nutritionist, outrageously and humorously debunking nutritional myths, including the myth that soy is a health food. And my topic today is how soybean oil took over in India, muscling out the traditional rapeseed or mustard oil. So for many, many years, oils were extracted with small oil presses and sold directly to housewives. It was a small-scale production, providing employment to thousands of artisans and ensuring that each household had fresh, non-rancid, healthy oils to use for their cooking. But that's the way it was. As reported by Vandana Shiva in her book Stolen Harvest, within just a few months of the advent of free trade that allowed soybean oil to be imported into India, thousands of Indians suddenly, mysteriously fell ill from dropsy. There was some sort of contamination of mustard seed oil, and nobody figured out what happened. But what the result was the government promptly banned the sale of all unpackaged edible oils, thus ensuring that all household and community-level processing of edible oils came to a halt. So that was the end of fresh and local. So edible oil production became fully industrialized, and local processing became a criminal act. Thousands of workers were suddenly unemployed, and millions of Indians were denied traditionally processed cooking oil. Instead, cheap, highly processed, unhealthy soy oil immediately replaced mustard oil in the marketplace. And what a surprise, throughout that crisis, the U.S. Soybean Association was busy pushing soybean imports as the solution. U.S. farmers, they said, need big new export markets, and India was the perfect match. I'm Dr. Kayla Daniel, the naughty nutritionist, and if this has been helpful, please do sign up for my YouTube channel, and please visit my website, drkayladaniel.com. Thank you.